Now that you've entered all your information into the graphic, you can decide whether you like the layout you have chosen. If not, you can select another layout in the Layouts group. Just hover over an option to see a live preview of the layouts on the slide. To see all the available layouts, scroll through the list or click the More drop-down arrow. Some of these will look good with your text, while others may not look quite right. Remember, some layouts can accommodate more text than others. If you find a layout you like, just click to select it. As soon as you do this, you'll notice the images in the SmartArt Styles group change. The styles that appear in this group are based on the layout you choose. I liked the previous layout better, so I'll just click Undo on the Quick Access toolbar, and my SmartArt graphic will change on the slide and in the SmartArt Styles group. In addition to changing the layout, you can change the color variation applied to the graphic and the SmartArt style. With the SmartArt graphic selected, just click the Change Color command on the Design tab. We can see a menu of color options, including ones related to the theme, some really colorful ones, and other variations of single colors. As you hover over an option, a live preview of it appears on the slide. To select one, just click it. As soon as you select a color, the SmartArt graphic on the slide will change, and the thumbnail images of the SmartArt graphic styles will change also. Now, if you want to apply a SmartArt style to the graphic, you can just hover over each option to see a live preview on the slide. To see more, you can scroll through the styles or click the More arrow to display all the options. There are some that PowerPoint determines are the best match for this presentation, and some other interesting options. Here, I like this simple one, so I'll just click it to select it. If at any time you want to go back to the original SmartArt graphic before you applied any colors or styles, just click Reset Graphic. I'm happy with my changes, so I'll leave it as it is. PowerPoint also gives you the ability to format the graphic so that it appears just like you want it to. When you inserted a SmartArt graphic, the Format tab appeared on the ribbon. These commands may look familiar to you because they are the same commands used with text boxes, shapes, and for applying word art. I like this circle to be a different color than the rest of the shapes since it is the center of the graphic. And maybe even have an effect to draw attention to it. Let's take a look at our organization hierarchy SmartArt graphic on slide 6. Just select the graphic, and then select the Design tab. When we were working on the last graphic, I mentioned that with some layouts, you can use the Promote and Demote commands in the Create Graphic group. We can use these commands on this graphic. For example, Carol Summer, the intern, has just been promoted to a designer. If you look at the brackets, currently she reports to Todd Ham, and he reports to Elizabeth Walter. To promote Carol, just select the shape and then click the Promote command. We can see the brackets move, and Carol and Todd both now report to Elizabeth. This was a very clear-cut change, but sometimes it is not that easy. For example, let's say that Jim has been promoted to head salesperson. Bob still manages the salespeople, but Jim has new responsibilities. When we click Promote to promote Jim, the graphic changes and Bob is no longer his boss. To make the charts correct, you can select Jim and then click the Add Shape command. From the menu, choose Add Shape Above. And now, a new shape appears that is above Jim and the other salespeople. We can just enter Bob's information and then delete the other shape. What I want you to understand is that you can use the commands in the Create Graphic group to format the graphic the way you wish. It may not always be as simple as clicking one command, but with these few tools, you can add and move shapes to create the graphic that meets your needs. I hope you can see how easy SmartArt graphics are to use and what a professional touch they add to the presentation.